Hello, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Tim, and we're back with more adventures. Teeny Tiny has decided to drop by and make a visit while she is recovering. Oh, you poor baby. You poor little baby. Oh, she's so sweet, and she's still trying to recover from her surgery, so she can't find a comfortable spot. Poor baby, I know it. Down you go. Because we have some chadventurers to kill. I mean, put through the paces. Let's do it. So, as we can see, our guild is getting pretty damn large by now. We actually have the new Hydromancer, which I'm kind of looking forward to getting to see what she can do. Actually, let me look at her real quick. Where's she at? The Alchemist, the Ranger of the Mime, and the Hydromancer. Nice. Fish, Storm, Ice Pun, Ice Cold, Tidal Wave, and Whirlpool. Where the enemy gains predictable if hero's discard pile has three or more cards. Interesting. So it's a lot of... it's a lot of card recycling and a lot of, making your opponent do the same. Interesting. Well, let's go exploring, shall we? As you can see, we have two of the areas done. And the last and final section of the Pirate's Cove is available to us. We also have some more of these level 3 quests to go, but I think we're going to hold off a while on that. So, we need an order, ladies and gentlemen. We need an order of operations. Who is brave enough to throw themselves at the Pirate's Eversail? The ship, the Eversail. Pirate skeletons, and now this? Who is brave enough to throw themselves at the challenges ahead? Who dares step forward? Harwood wants to go first. I admire your bravery, my friend. Where were you at? I know I saw you. Harwood, the mime. Okay. You got it, my friend. You have 8 hearts at your disposal, plus the Phlogist Tonic. Here we go. So let's see what we've got first. A ghost that will be chasing us. The ghostly pirate, who has Bulwark on his mind. Where if he takes exactly 1 damage on a turn, we can prevent said damage. It looks like he's going to be chasing after us. So, do we go after the one-headed monkey, or do we go after the deckhand? The deckhand has stupidity on our side, so I think we'll go ahead and go with the deckhand. And he's going to start off with a nice hearty parry. But the good news is, he's totally not going to be able to block any of our attacks here. Presuming that he continues to have that, really? Of course it cloned his stupidity card. Of course it did. Oh, and you're also hulking. I didn't realize that you had the extra benefit of being hulking. That's kind of nice. And now we can make him discard that very high damage card that he had coming up next. We can block his imaginary box, or block his strike with our imaginary box. In comes another thrash. Damn it, I should have done another thrash. Oh well, we can match the amount of damage that he does to us, at least, so that way to make it a little bit more of a fair fight. And in he comes with an unblockable lunge, but that unblockable lunge is not going to make a damn bit of difference against our magnificent stage presence. Good job! Good job, Harwood! You totally got it. So, you have your first choice, my friend. The Leatherbound Tome, which will give you Mind Strike or Fire Blast. You have the Grenade, which would give you Flame Blast and Flame Lash, a nice quick 2 magic damage there. Considering that you have a lot of storing up of magic damage already, those would not be bad choices either way. And then the Soldier's Helmet, which would give you just straight up another heart. Another heart would not be bad. So, what would you like, my friend? Harwood, your choice. The choices are yours. No. Good luck. Harwood wants the grenade. You got it, my friend. I'm thinking that quick attack is probably going to make the difference between living and dying at some point in the future. Oh, the ghostly pirate continues on his haunting ways. Can we get lucky with a fountain? Yay! We got lucky with a fountain. And I'm actually going to go ahead and... Oh, we don't have any physical damage to do against him. Damn it. Damn it. Us and our lack of physical damage. But it's okay. We'll put a cook in front of the ghost, see how it likes the taste of its own crooked flesh. And incoming spook. Which, thankfully, we're going to be able to just get around because it's blocking physical damage. And again, we don't have any of that. Goodbye, Zap. I would rather take the regular spark than the actual, probably really damaging, Zap. And unfortunately, we lose our imaginary cannon, but that's okay. Oh, we do have a little bit of physical damage. That's kind of nice, because now that becomes a two physical attack instead of just one. Kind of worth using. Kind of totally worth using. Ow. And now we'll make you discard a card, too. You know what? I would rather be able to recycle a card than... whatever. We'll take that, too. And we have... Aha! Harwood, I told you. I fucking told you that this Flame Lash was going to make the difference between living and dying. And that was exactly what happened. That is literally exactly what happened right there. If we had not had that quick attack come up when it did, this would be an in, this would a run. I mean, the run would be over. That'd be it. That'd be another dead mime added to the top of the pile. But you chose wisely. And so, you came out on top. We have another choice for you, sir. The Scroll of Souls, which of course gives you all of those wonderful starting points for other skills to build off of. Arcane 2 and Holy 2 at your disposal. And we have the Fez, which will give you Wise, Mind Strike, and Focus. And then we have the Anchor, which would give you Bash and Slam at the cost of your Fire Blast and Flame Lash. The choices are yours and yours alone. Good luck. It's a good time for that Captain Falcon emote, Harwood. A really good time for that. Okay. Scroll of Souls it is. I mean, look, that has not been an unwise decision for anyone that has picked it thus far, okay? And we have the that Fountain of Clairvoyance, too, which is going to be really, really helpful come the next fight. We'll be able to see pretty much any card that they're going to play against us. So, do we take on the Ancient Mariner, who has Decay and Rum, whom we might be able to put the spanking on. Ooh, but this three-headed monkey, though. This three-headed monkey that has Mundane. I'm thinking the three-headed monkey. The bad news is we don't have any more rooms to lay out. So we're just basically going to have to head ourselves off at the pass here. The Ancient Mariner has exactly the same amount of health as the three-headed monkey, but not as many attributes. And that decay, there's a lot of times we'll be due two or more damage, so that could be really nice. But most of our attacks are magic attacks, and so that makes it do one additional damage no matter what the damage is. But that fury, though. Okay, we're just gonna take the Ancient Mariner. Fuck it. I don't want to face down that fury. I just don't. I'm a big old chicken shit when it comes to that. I would rather have him have these attributes and be able to ruin his day by that decay. Watch this. I mean, that's about to be three. He takes another one from decay. Yeah, I know. The Ancient Mariner was absolutely the way to go. We're gonna cause him another... plus one damage. Love it. And Flame Lash is going to finish off the job without barely breaking a sweat. Yeah, the Ancient Mariner was definitely the way to go. And Harwood, you have another choice. The Red Mail, which would give you Repel and plus one Heart. Not a bad choice, my friend. And the Winged Staff, which would replace your Bomb, but give you Arcane Barrage, Blinding Light, and Divine Shield. Look at that you would be getting from that. Ugh, blocking all magic damage, having a 3 unblockable attack, and blocking 2 and gaining and healing 2. It might actually be worth losing that quick. But anyway, and then you also have the Winged Fury, which will give you Retribution and blinding light. That same blinding light you would get from the winged staff. So yeah. Harwood, you have a tough choice ahead of you, my friend. I do not envy you. But choose wisely. It will influence the rest of your playstyle. Harwood wants the staff. You got it, my friend. Blinding light, arcane barrage, and divine shield are yours. He said it, Queen. He said it. I have to listen. I have to listen to him. There'll be plenty of more opportunities for leveling up, I assure you. And plenty more items to get. The ship's cook has fury, respite, and rum. I would still rather take on the three-headed monkey. So let's do that. And I'm going to set out another dungeon path, and you take on a monkey too. Let's do it. All right, Harwood. Let's see how well your choice has worked for you. The good news is we're not really going to have to worry about anything regarding this bulwark because, well, we do way more damage than he's going to be able to block from us. Like this. That is now a 3 magic damage attack instead of 2. He's going to hit us with Body Slam, and that is now a 4 magic damage dealing arcane barrage. And suddenly this 3-headed monkey looks like it's been mother plucked just a little bit too hard. He takes 1 damage, we deal 2, draw a card, and draw another victory from the jaws of defeat. Harwood, you have another choice to make, my friend. You have the Feathered Cap, which would give you Rekindle and Restore, which combined with that Holy Light gives you a whole bunch more healing at your disposal. And then you have the Bone Armor, which would give you +1 heart and Cerebrate. Holy shit, dude. That is a great choice. And then the Broken Bottle, which would replace your staff, but give you Shift, Slice, and Rekindle. So, my friend, the choices are yours and yours alone. Good luck. What shall you choose? I believe in you, Harwood. I believe in your ability to make wise decisions when it comes to equipment choices. You know that it's going to make or break you for the rest of this run. So what's it gonna be? What's it gonna be? The Bone Armor gives you +1 heart and Cerebrate. And then the Feathered Cap gives you Rekindle and Restore. Both magic damage dealing, both restoring. Well, Restore only actually gives you the 2 hearts if you hit with that attack. You know what, Queen? That is a damn good combination. And welcome back, Scorch. Harwood chooses the Bone Armor, and he gains another heart in the process, which I think that now we definitely have more hearts than this ghost pirate does. By a lot. Alright, I'm thinking one or two more battles, probably. Let's go ahead and go on down. Ship's cook, because you're still missing a headpiece. You have a good weapon, you have the Scroll of Souls at your disposal, but all you're missing is a good headpiece. Let me go ahead and stage presence, because I want to see what's coming up next. Ooh, remove that stupid headbutt. So all he's got is stupidity at his disposal, and we can hit him hard with a nice decay at the end of it. And another smite comes his way, and this should actually finish him off. Let me tell you the tale of the ancient mariner. He died like a bitch because he was a bitch. Shut up. You do better. Come on. You have the conch, Harwood. You have the owl familiar. And you have the wooden shield at your disposal. The wooden shield gives you repel and tenacious. The owl familiar gives you wise. And the conch gives you nothing, basically. It gives you no good attributes, but you would lose things. Yeah. Harwood wants the gold. I think that's a good decision. And so now at this point, now that we are at level 4, now that we're kind of at a decent distance from the ghost and murdering lots of dudes, I will give you the option that I give every time we get at this point. Harwood, at any time you want, you may tell me to turn around and kick that ancient ghost right in his ghostly testicles, because that is 100% coming. So, whenever you want to, my friend, whenever you think you're ready to take on the ancient ghost, because I believe in you. Oh, don't you dare make me discard that blinding light. God damn it. Hello, Leftshart. Welcome back. Glad you could join us. I'm going to hit him with the imaginary cannon, which, I mean, with the addition of the one that he does to himself, will totally destroy that ass and trigger that decay. Let's go ahead and deal a smite, which is now going to deal 3 magic damage and death. That spells all the death for him. And Harwood, you have another choice. You have the Sword of the Sea, which will replace your Cerebrate, Blinding Light, and Divine Shield with Slice, Dice, Rekindle, Restore, and Refresh. The Wooden Shield, which will do that, and the Winged Staff, which would, well, give you 3 gold, basically. So what would you like, my friend? We can try and roll for more gold, see if we can get another massive gem, or you can take the assured 3 that comes from the Winged Staff. What shall you do, my friend? Okay, the guaranteed 3 it is. And we'll pick up the gem at the same time. So, since you haven't said to stop yet, I'm going to lay down another piece of corridor, a gem, and a mariner. Let's do this. I really want to get you a headpiece. Like, that would be so great. We'll go ahead and heal back the one that he just did, draw another card, and store up a magic damage. And we are going to make this shit hurt. Give him a smite from downtown, which deals 4 damage. An incoming arcane barrage, which deals 3 damage, plus his headbutt damage, plus a decay. And the ancient mariner goes down in, I think, like 3 rounds. That literally was not long at all. Okay, Harwood, here we go. You have the wolf pelt, which would replace Cerebrate with Rekindle and Restore. The Battle Axe, which would replace Cerebrate, Blinding Light, and Divine Shield with Bash, Slam, Slice, Dice, and Eviscerate. Not too shabby. I mean, those are not bad trade-offs right there. And then the Masquerade Mask. Really? We are already at maximum skill levels. No more battle cards are currently available. Huh. Well, shit, Harwood. It seems that we are, in fact, at our most powerful. So you can go ahead and take the mask and have it on your face and have all 4 items. It just won't actually do anything. I've never seen that before. That is new. At maximum skill levels. I assume that that means that Arcane and Holy are already at their maximum. And if we were to get another headpiece, we would be able to get some stats off of it. But our Arcane and our Holy are at their most powerful, so we can't take those stats anymore, is what that means. Okay, you got it. I mean, here's the thing. We still have a couple of turns before we can actually get to him because of the way the movement works. So, we can try one more ship's cook just to see if we get a better headpiece. And, who knows? Who the fuck knows? He's got a respite, and... yeah, that means that we have to damage him every turn. Every turn. Or else he's gonna heal, and we do not want that. He's gonna try and ransack and steal some cards from me, but that's only if he's successful. Incoming pommel, that's not going to feel great, but we can block one, hit him back for one, and he doesn't heal this turn. We still got it. We got to damage him. Cool. So we got a headbutt off on him. I'm going to go ahead and, I guess, do the same back to him. We need to damage him as much as we can before he starts doing bad shit like this. I'm going to imaginary cannon him. And in comes the Fury. He's gonna try and beat it. But we're bad. So our mighty stage presence means that we're gonna make him get rid of Thrash. And all he's got is Yoink. Guess what, motherfucker? You can't Yoink around magic damage. Oh, and that rum comes into play. Of course the rum comes into play. Okay, let's block one of those damages, and that'll let me store up a magic. Hopefully we'll get a nice magic damage dealing attack here. Divine Shield comes in. Oh, no! No! No, no, no! Harwood, no!
Oh, fuck me! God damn it! God damn it! God damn it!
We had our eyes on the prize. We had our eyes on the prize, and it cost me my mime. And I'm really, really upset about it. God damn it. And so we return to the guild with our tail between our legs. Ugh. God damn it. We're that close. Okay, well, I guess that means Noble's up next. Noble, how you feeling? Pretty good? Pretty drunk? Pretty sailory? It's time to send you back where you belong. I did, Queen. I absolutely did, but it happens. Okay, so let's try this again. Corridor. Monkey, deckhand. And let's see what we would do to keep a drunken sailor alive. Maybe let him actually get some battle scars. He's got hulking and arcane one at his disposal, so this could be really fun. Do we use the reckless swing or do we save up? Yeah, I think we'll go ahead and use it. I mean, the bad news is, Harwood, all I could have really done is just kind of like tried to go straight for him and bite a couple of turns. And I guess I could have done that, but I really, really wanted to get you a good headpiece. Okay. So, Noble, you have your first choice, my friend. The fish scale cowl, which will give you another heart and also that focus. I don't think you have many magic damage dealing attacks, though. But you do have one from your battle scar. So you do actually have some magic damage in there somewhere. You have Arcane Wand. And that focus will help. The Arcane Wand gives you Rekindle and Focus. And the Demon Claw gives you Slice and Dice. We know that there's a lot of unblockable damage around here. So that Dice may not be a bad decision to take. But what do you choose, Noble? I leave it up to you, my friend. Choose wisely. Noble wants that Demon Claw. You got it. We're gonna slice and dice our way through the enemies. Out of my way, you stupid monkey. And we have sea monkeys. Let's see how you like some aquatic shit. You stupid ghost pirate. The good news is we're actually way stronger than this sea monkey, and all it has is a whole bunch of magic damage that it can throw at us that we can't really block. But he's gonna try and steal one of my cards, so we have to make it one that we kind of want him to have. Let's do another reckless swing because he can't really block it, unfortunately. He's gonna come in with a bite. All we have is stupidity, which sucks. And charge. Good. We won another one. Good job, Noble. Get ready to make another decision, my friend. You have some loots to choose from. We have the broadsword, which would replace your claws and give you ferocious and bash. We have the fez, which would give you wise, focus, and arcane barrage. Not too bad to have around here. And then the spiky hat, which would, oh my Christ, give you eviscerate, bleed, and repel. Well, my friend, what would you like, Noble? I believe in the power of your decision-making. What do you want? I believe in the power of the drunken sailor. He's kicked a bunch of ass, and I haven't really helped out a whole lot with that. That's just been you, dude. That's just been you and your natural awesomeness as a drunken sailor. And we got that spiky hat. I love that it just sits ever so slightly a kilter atop your head. I think that's really funny. Okay, so at level 3, we're dealing a whole bunch of damage right now, and I'm thinking that an ancient mariner is going to be a good idea. Let's go and put a monkey in its path. Yeah, I know what you mean, Noble. Having more cards is always better. But I feel like, God, that spiky helmet, though. That spiky helmet, though. Come on. We're going to go ahead and start out with a nice hearty bleed, which is actually going to trigger the decay in and of itself, and then another bleed damage to start with. So let's... I'm going to go ahead and squinty-eye my way through this headbutt, because I feel like, yep, that decay was caused by the bleed and also the damage that he caused to himself. Let's go ahead and repel. That should cause the decay. And then the burn hits. Yeah. Yeah, no, we're good here. Burn. He's gonna hit himself again, and this is gonna be it. This is the end of the round. Overkill. Overkill. And bleed damage makes even more overkill. Awesome, Noble. So you have another choice. The Cursed Bow, which gives you decay yourself and ranged, and also shift and interrupt. And again, and then the Warhorn, which will give you Fire Blast, Rekindle, and Holy Seal. And also just the sword, which we already have the maximum battle level for Blade, so you don't really need that right now. Blade is at 4, and so it gives you Slice, Dice, Eviscerate, and Bleed, thanks to your helmet and the claws that you have. You want Horn? Okay, my friend. Fire, Growth, and Holy are now yours. And so this is what they were talking about when they were talking about skill levels. You see here that Blade is at level 4. And so it has 4 cards that it gives you inside of your deck, okay? We have 1 armor card, which gives you repel, 1 holy card, 1 growth card, 1 arcane card, 1 stupidity card, and 1 fire card. And those are what they all give you. Now, as you get other items that give you Fire 2, Fire 3, Fire 4, they give you the appropriate number and level of cards in your deck. That's the way the skills end up working around here. So, let's get another Ancient Mariner in front of us, and another monkey group in front of him. Alright, Noble. I want to get you a piece of armor. And then I'm just not even gonna fuck around anymore. I learned my lesson last time. We're just gonna go straight for the boss. Incoming strike that I'm gonna take out with a reckless swing of my own. I feel like I'm gonna save this eviscerate for a rainy day. Like, oh, I don't know. Not now. We're good. We hit him with that. The decay hits him and it hurts. The ancient mariner dies either way, whether it be of old age or of our own volition. So we have another Warhorn for you to choose from. The Mariner's Medallion would actually replace Fire Blast and Rekindle with Blessed, giving you +1 to all healing, which unfortunately we don't have a whole lot of. The Bone Helmet would give you Focus and Arcane Barrage at the cost of all of those other blade skills. So, what do you want, my friend? Would you like to just take the gold, or do you want the Warhorn? The Warhorn would give you gold without us having to lay one out to pick up. So that's kind of the big advantage of taking the gold that way over taking a gold card. Cash proper, not the horn. You got it. Then in that case, I'm going to go ahead and lay out this massive gem up here so it's not used in vain. And in turn. Yeah, but if he gets the bone helmet, he'll lose this really awesome spiked helmet that he has equipped already. And there's no way we want to lose that bitch. It is way too good. And you take an Ancient Mariner. You take an Ancient Mariner. You take an Ancient Mariner. Ancient Mariner's for everybody! I believe in you. I believe in you. I believe in you, Noble. And the choices that you have made here today. Let us hit him with a Fire Blast so we can trigger more decay. I like the sound of decay in the morning. Let's use another Squinty Eye, which I think is going to make us deal holy fuck loads of damage with this next attack. I think that was like 6. I'm pretty sure that was 6 physical damage that we did with that. And so now, Noble, you have another choice. The Conch, which would give you Focus, Arcane Barrage, Cerebrate, and also Stupidity 2. At the cost of Fire Blast, Rekindle, and Holy Seal. You have the Bone Helmet, which would give you Focus and Arcane Barrage, and then the Heater Shield, which would replace Rekindle and Holy Seal with +1 Heart and Flame Lash. I don't know, that almost seems worth it. Like, getting that Quick Attack and +1 Heart, which, I mean, we haven't really done a whole lot of healing anyway, almost seems like it's worth it. But so is the power of the Conch. I mean, Fire Blast, Rekindle, and Holy Seal are totally worth it for Arcane Barrage, Cerebrate, and Focus. Which Focus, you know, less good for the actual magic damage, but really good for the healing and the drawing of a card. So you could replace the Warhorn here and not be too far gone from your playstyle. So what do you want, Noble? Choose wisely. We're about to take on a very deadly ghost pirate. Noble wants the power of the Conch! I can't say that I blame you! And we're gonna start weaseling our way back forward here. Curiosity begs the question. Will you be a good fountain? Yes! You will, in fact, be a good fountain. So good, in fact, I am declaring this the last round. Once we get that fountain, we're gonna take on the ghost. And that headbutt comes in. Okay. Let's use the focus now to heal up, draw a card, and store a magic damage at our disposal. We have now this Arcane Barrage, which is gonna do 4 damage, plus the one from decay, so the Ancient Mariner's dead. Awesome. And now we have another choice. God damn it, I still can't get you any fucking armor at all. We have the sword, we have the bone helmet, and we have the feathered cap. Gold? I'm assuming gold. I'm gonna guess that you want the gold. Because unfortunately, the heart of the cards is just not with you when it comes to choosing another armor. Okay. Let's lay out a massive gem here, and I'm gonna lay out one here too. Give me a fight inside of the fountain room, so that way we'll actually hopefully have one more chance of getting a piece of armor without losing the power that is inside Pokemon. In comes the Reckless Swing and the decay damage. And let's see how well we can do here. I'm gonna slice my way through and activate another decay. Love it. And with his stupidity, we can go and use this chance to squint our eye a little bit and get some extra damage coming down the tubes. Yarr. This eviscerate attack is now 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 damage strong. And that feels pretty good. Noble, your squinty eye being able to stack is fucking amazing. And now we have another choice. The sword, the padded vest, which would just give you counter, because you already have Arcane at the max level, so it would give you Armor 2, which was Counter and also the Repel that you have already. Yeah, Repel and then Counter. Or the Horned Helm, which would replace Bleed and Repel with Fury. I mean, really, it's a vest. Whatever it is, it doesn't fucking matter. It gives you more blocking capability, does it not? Take it. At this point, you just take what the game will give you. You got it, my friend. Let's go ahead and take this fountain as ours, and it's time to kill this ghost pirate. Ending turn for Harwood, whom I unfortunately murdered. I apologize profusely for it. All right, ghost pirate, you have met your maker. Well, your other maker. It seems like you met that one a long time ago. I'm going to hit you with this reckless swing. Shut up. And of course, it would take my other big damage attack, didn't it? Ooh, look at that. Block you. Deal 3 damage to it, and I am just completely avoiding this bulwark altogether. It's gonna hit me with Black Strike, and thanks to the fountain that we have, let's block. See what happens. Okay, that was blocks on blocks. Blocks on blocks on blocks. He's gonna use our squinty eye that he stole, and it's not gonna help him one single iota. We just busted that motherfucking ghost. Noble, good job. You did it. Everything has gone wrong. You did it. There was no reason why we couldn't have done it earlier. And I feel really bad now for getting Harwood killed. He had a really good mime. But we got revenge. And now Harwood can reclaim his throne. Good. So, with the first mission of the Pirate's Cove done, we can expand our guild even more to unlock more epic items. The Gnarled Oak, the Voodoo Mask, the Trident, the Coat of Thorns, the Rum Barrel, and the Long Coat are what are being shown off here right now. And then we have the Net, the Wolf Hat, the Dueling Buckler, the Dragon Scale, Seaweed, and the Ocean Staff. I'm thinking the chisel. Let's go with the chisel. For now. I mean, we're definitely going to get all of the rest of the items before we get anything else in that expanding guild. I'm just curious where the good items really lie. Also, look at this giant-ass graveyard. I can't wait till I am able to make the giant JPEG. I want to make it a poster. Like, that's what I would, in an ideal world, I would love to make that JPEG into a poster that I just run along, like, a corner of the wall or something. I think that would be really cool. Okay, let's go exploring, shall we? We have an Eversail to, make a liar out of. And in order to do that, I am in a great need. I'm in a great need for a song and a dance and maybe the captain's head on a lance. Is that so much to ask, really? I think the troubadour can deliver that to me. Grab me this loot, troubadour! Let's go. So now, this ghost pirate captain is trying to keep us from collecting 3 mega chests. And they're being heavily guarded by some ghost pirates. Wow. That are actually more deadly than the boss we just faced, I'll have you know. Let's go and lay that out, and a deckhand. Deckhand going forward. I feel like this troubadour is gonna make quick work of a deckhand. So you're up, Queen. I believe in you. He's got a stupidity to start out with, and that spell sword's gonna come in handy. Arcane Swipe, Ice Blast, so that he can't deal with me. I don't think so. Not today, Junior. I'm gonna parry 2 of your physical damage and deal back 3 of my own, which puts this deck hand right squat in the dirt. We kicked him right in the poop deck. How you feeling about that, Queen? I have a choice for you, my dear. And because of your battle scars, your Scrounger Battle Scar gives you the ability to have 1 loot choice, this stiletto, that is better than the rest. So you have a level 2 stiletto with Slice and Shift. You have the Bandana na 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 na, which gives you Repel and Shift. And the Leather-Bound Tome to give you Mind Strike and Fire Blast. You want the Bandana? Okay. And so we get a couple of coinages out of that too. I want to start looping this around as quickly as possible. And you do have some magic damage, so killing this werecrab mage, I mean, really, like, this is what you're made for, Queen. This is exactly what you're made for. He has frail, and it matters not a single iota to me. Not one single fucking bit. We're gonna deliver some major frail damage here. And incoming black stripe, which we'll be able to leap most of the way over and deliver three more damage of our own. I want an ice blast. Excellent. And that gives us that spell sword trait. And spike. And that quick fucking spike damage. Awesome. Okay, Queen, you won another battle. You have another choice, my dear. The cultist hood, which would give you fire blast, holy seal, and smite. The broadsword to give you ferocious and bash. And then the padded vest, which would give you mind strike, focus, and counter, giving you arcane 2 and armor 1. What do you want, my dear? Queen, you have a choice for you. Yeah, I'm sure, Queen, but it's okay. I still want it in my own time. The broadsword is of an epic loot choice, and the padded vest and the cultist hood are of the tier 2. Okay, broadsword it is. Physical damage attacks dealing 3 plus damage get 1 extra bonus. So we gotta make you a physical damage dealing connoisseur. And I also kinda wanna start curving around towards this first chest. Considering that you're already at level 3. Let's give you another monkey to contend with here, so we can get a third item under your belt before we take on our first ghost. I'm actually going to leap over your wave and deal 2 physical damage of our own. That is a damn good way to deal with this stupid monkey. And we'll deal 1 magical damage to activate the spell sword. Ooh. Don't strike back in anger, I heard him say, because that gets you killed. That sea monkey put itself 6 feet under. Like, we didn't even have to do anything for that one. I just kind of let him back and let him spank his own red baboon ass. And speaking of red baboon ass, how about a red mail for you, Queen? Do you want a red mail? Or do you want another broadsword? Or maybe the tricorn hat, which would replace your repel and shift with slice and dice. The choices are yours and yours alone. Red mail. You got it, my dear. And now, we have the ghost pirates, which will start chasing you as soon as we connect those loops. We have to remember that. Let us leap over its magical damage, deal 2 physical of our own, and remember that it has bulwark and aggressive. The aggressive isn't going to come into play during combat, but that's the thing that makes it chase us. And let's go ahead and deal arcane strike so we can deal some magical damage of our own, making this next physical attack hurt like a motherfucker. I think I'm gonna use counter. Yeah, so that way it still deals 3 damage. He steals 1 of our cards, but it's not our good card, which is the good news. Let's use shift. Oh no! That bulwark came into play. No! I should have used the other one. God damn it. Fine, you're not stealing that card. Ugh, arcane swipe it is. He's gonna heal, we get some more physical, and then the giant spike comes in to crash him back to Earth. And so, Queen, you have another choice. The Mind Staff, which will replace your broadsword with Wise, Mind Strike, and Fire Blast. The Power of the Conch, which would give you Mind Strike, Focus, and Arcane Barrage, as well as a Stupidity card. And then the Battle Axe, which would replace your Ferocious with Slam, Slice, Dice, and Eviscerate. That is literally straight up Blade 4. Like, you would get Blade 4 and also Crush 2. So, that's not bad. That's not bad at all. Replacing your broadsword with a battle axe is pretty good idea. Getting the conch is a great idea because that's a whole lot of magical damage to trigger that spell sword ability. So, I don't know. It really depends on the way you want to play, Queen. Do you want to trigger that spell sword more often, or do you want to give us just all the fucking damage, dude? Just all the damage. The choices are yours and yours alone. Good luck. Yeah, it really is, Queen. Almost. But you have to make the choice. It's not me. Okay, the conch it is. And I mean, really, we're about to take a mega chest. And inside of a mega chest is usually mega loots. So what do we have here? Damn. We have the long coat, which gives you show off, interrupt, and fleet footed at the cost of plus one hard encounter. Show off is a new attribute that means if you take no damage this turn, plus one physical damage on the next turn. The Masquerade Mask at level 3 gives you Cerebrate, Holy Seal, and Smite at the cost of counter and shift. And then we also have the Bone Helmet, which just gives you Cerebrate at the cost of counter and shift as well. So really, the Masquerade Mask would be the way to go if you wanted to replace your bandana. The long coat would make you lose the attributes from the red mail, but it'd give you some pretty good stuff. So I don't know. It depends on what you want, Queen. Do you want to just take the gold? We still have a lot of chests to open and a lot of battles before us. You got it. The long coat it is to replace that red mail. And you are, in fact, completely loaded down for bear at this point. You are ready for any battles that this game is going to throw at you. Let's end our turn. I mean, really, all that's left is two ghost pirates and two chests. So we'll be able to get pretty much anything we want there. Really. I'm going to go ahead and put that there. I know, really, it should go here if I wanted to actually connect it over to where we need to go. But whatever. It's not my problem. Sweet. We'll connect up. Connect over. And please be a good fountain. Fuck you. Fuck you. And now the ghost pirate's going to start coming for us. Now that we have connected the two places, it's going to start coming for our butts. Unfortunately, I have no real way of connecting over here to this one yet. So I guess we'll just hold off for now. In turn, continue to wander into the breach. I did forget to place the crystal. I kind of thought that I would be out of moves by the time I got to the big gym, and I just, well, didn't. So we have some big arcane barrage coming its way. And that means that we're gonna have some good spike damage from this with the ferocious trait on. Yeah, that was good. That was a good move. Let's go ahead and use a parry here. Oh, shit. And she yoinked both of the cards that we fucking had. God damn it. Wow. That instantly put us at a huge disadvantage. But we still win thanks to that ferocious trait that Queen picked up a while ago. I'm actually kind of really glad that you didn't exchange it for the battle axe now, because that would have really fucked us over. So, Queen, what would you like this time? A long coat? The wolf's pelt to replace your coat with a plus one heart, rekindle and restore. And then the scaled mail, which would replace it with plus two hearts and counter. It's basically the upgraded version of this, the red mail that we had a little bit ago. The choices are yours and yours alone. Do you just want gold? Okay, you got it. Another long coat it is. And with a mounting sense of dread, we walk forward to the Fountain of Stupidity. Ugh. All right, fine. I can't put that up there, but I can put those up here. So now we have a couple of different ways with which we can try and make it up. And let's go ahead and get another chest. Damn it. So we have the Sword of the Sea, which would replace your longsword with all of that shit. Not bad. At the cost of Ferocious and Bash. Then we have the Mace, which would replace Ferocious with Slam and Slice. And then we have the Scale Mail, which would replace your Show-Off Coat with plus two hearts and counter. So what would you like, my dear? Would you like the Sword of the Sea? Or would you like to just take some gold? Gimme gold. You got it, my dear. I am going to, I guess, connect these 2 points because it's the best and only thing that I can do right now. Let's put some gold in the way and end our turn. Now we begin the long and slow and arduous trudge over to where we might find this next beastie. I'm going to lay a buttload of gems in your way, Queen. Just all the gold that we can put in there. How about another one? And this one we can actually put right here. Excellent. Bad news is it's still not one that gets us over to where we need, but you know what? Whatever. In turn. And no more gold to unfortunately place in your way. 1, 2. Oh, yeah. Yeah, I could totally do that. I should totally do that. Damn it. Yet another fucking group of rooms that doesn't help me at all. All right, Ancient Mariner. You never stood a chance. Not a single fucking chance. Against this show-off? Are you kidding me? Let's go ahead and repel, which means we'll take that extra +1 damage. I'm going to go ahead and use Arcane Swipe here to charge up another +1 physical damage. We use Fleet Footed to use that up and make it ferocious and show off and kill that ancient fucking mariner. My gods. And so, Queen, you have another choice. We can get the Spiked Shield, which gives you Spiky, Slice, Dice, and Counter at the cost of all of those abilities down below. The Mind Staff, which would replace your sword with all of those. Or the Masquerade Mask to replace your bandana with Cerebrate, Holy Seal, and Smite. What would you like, my dear? The choices are yours and yours alone. Good luck. Oh my god, that 10-hour mark just passed and I can feel it. I can feel it. Okay, Spike and Shield it is. You got it. Fuck. I mean, it is the curve that I need. It's just one too early. I need one straight across, one straight horizontal, and then I'll be able to curve down into the pirate. Still nothing. Still fuck all nothing. I'm getting screwed by the dungeon tiles at this point. Let's do that. I mean, what other choice do I have, you know? Oh, of course. You would take the bad fountain, wouldn't you, Queen? All right, I'll give you another fight. And I still got nothing. I still got absolutely bubkus. We can turn down for what? That decay, though. All right, let's hit him with some hard spike damage, which activates his decay and our own show off because we didn't take any damage that turn. Let's go fleet-footed to make it ferocious and decay. And he hurts himself for 1. We get a decay 2. Unfortunately, that did activate his rum. Damn it. But it's okay. We'll go ahead and hit him with an Ice Blast. And, of course, this counter will finish him off. I'm not discarding a card today. Spike damage comes in. And Queen just eviscerated that guy. Man, she made that look easy. Mariner's Medallion to raise your healing. Horned Helm to give you Fury and Eviscerate. Or the Broken Bottle to give you Haste and Eviscerate and Rekindle. What do you want, my dear? That haste would be really nice because then it's a guaranteed, it's an almost guaranteed fucking spike damage unless we just have to use it on attack where they don't attack us, you know, something like that, something bullshit like that. And she wants gold instead. You got it. Okay, I want you to go here instead. Massive gem. Yeah, it looks like we're gonna end up having to go the long way around. This is fucking dumb. I mean, the good news is we're basically just sitting here collecting gems all day. You know, this is not a bad way to live life if you had to choose. But the question is, can I actually combine these two routes somehow before we end up going all the fuck the way back around? Because that's going to take a lot of turns that I just don't want to waste. Yep, and here comes the ghost. It's going to seek us out through every single one of those stupid fucking routes until it finds us. And by that point, we might have actually been able to break in through here instead. Wouldn't that be funny? Go ahead and maybe go around this way too. I don't know. I honestly don't know. Yeah, I agree, Kisty. It just means more gold for us. So we can actually come through here or through here, depending on which one we find first. Fuck. What is even happening? What is even happening right now? Game, give me the proper dungeon tiles so that I may complete this mission. Thank fucking Christ. Thank fucking Pirate Christ on a holy crouton cracker that Polly totally wants. We finally made it around. Will we make it before the ghost? Probably not. Will we make it at the same time as the ghost? Probably not. You know what's funny, Queen? There's actually an achievement for making a dungeon floor that is more than 50 tiles. So I kind of want to do that at some point. That would be really funny. I don't think we're close right now, but I could have Noble, but I just don't feel like it. Seriously, why? We can destroy that guy. We can make his day so terrible for him. And of course, we're probably going to end up missing both of those fountains. But it's okay. We see that massive chest, and all that stands between us and it is a simple ghost pirate battle. I think we can do this. I'm 99.99% sure we can do this. Spike damage, that regular damage. Let's block a little bit of this. Thanks to the power of our interrupt, he only gains conceal for this one round. And I kind of want to try dice just in case. Nope. Damn. I was hoping it would be something unblockable. Okay. He's gonna heal one damage. Let's deal two and make it so that our next attack hurts doubly worse as well. Unfortunately, he is going to get in a yoink. But thanks to our ferocious, it's not gonna matter because, well, that ghost pirate is re-dead. And we have a coat of thorns. And the cavalier's hat and the war horn for you to take, Queen. But guess what? This battle's fucking over. So we're just going to take some gold, put it right in the way of this chest. Oh, wait. We can't. Oh, man. And go straight for victory. Oh, glorious mega chest. Queen has unlocked you and gained a new battle scar in the process. Queen, you are now hard-headed. And also, you have this trait, which gives you plus one heart and minus one starting hand size in battle. Ouch. So we can either keep hard-headed and keep our Phlogist Tonic the way it is, or switch over to the Witch's Tonic and make it so that we regain that plus one hand size and just basically average out until your hard-headed levels up further. You know what I mean? To where it might actually drop that stat off. That would be kind of the ideal scenario here. But anyway, we have reached the end of our first hour, ladies and gentlemen. Don't you dare go anywhere, because when we come back, we have the final mission of the Eversail, where the loser has to walk the plank. That's right, ladies and gentlemen. Who's going to get the gold? Who's going to be in the drink? We'll find out when we come back. You're watching this on twitch.tv/TimLeftwich. My name is Tim Leftwich. We'll be right back.